lesson today is talking about what happens when we take a power and we raise it to another power. Okay, so with your note catcher, make sure you are following along as I demonstrate the board. So in order to figure out what the rule is when we do a power to a power, the best way to do it is to expand it. So if I have three to the third power and it's all raised to the fourth, what that tells me first is that 3 to the third is being multiplied by itself a total of 4 times. All right, then within each 3 to the third power, that's saying it's also getting multiplied another 3 times. All right, so for each 3 to the third, we're multiplying 3 times. So that brings us with a total of 3 to the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12th power. So we do 3 to the 3rd raised to the 4th. It gives us 3 to the 12th power. That's how I write it as a single base. This next one is n to the 3rd, the power of 6. Same thing as we did up here. We know that n to the 3rd is being multiplied a total of 6 times. Okay, same thing again. It would be n that many times. So if I count it all up, I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So this is n to the 18th, okay? So based on what we discovered in the first two problems, you're probably thinking about your idea for the rule. Well, right, if it's base, and it's being raised to some power n, m, that's also being raised to the power of n, well, it is b to the power of m times m. We look up here, right? 3 times 4 gives me that 12. Over here, 6 times 3 gives me 18. So make sure when you're doing a power rule versus a product rule, the power has to be raised by a second power. All right, now let's move on to the triet. All right, so now the triet, we're gonna practice. So if I have 5 to the 6th, all raised to the power of 5 to the 9th, I'm not gonna write out 5 to the 6th 9 times and then expand it further. Now I'm just gonna use my rule. So if we think about it, if it's all one base, 5 to the power of 6, and that's getting multiplied 9 times, this becomes 5 to the 54ths. With B, same thing, we're containing negative, so it's negative 8 to the power of 5 times 3, which is 15. Same thing with variables we've been doing before. X to the 3 times 7 gives me x to the 21st power. Over here, all right, I have m plus 1 to the power of 20, because I'm multiplying my powers. Now this last one, your triet, it's determining is 3 to the power of 5 raised to the power of 7, is that equal to 3 to the 12th? Well, since it's power to a power, it's 3 to the power of 5 times 7, which in fact gives me 3 to the power of 35. So this is not equal. So now we're gonna move on to the product of a power. So your second page of your note catcher, okay? Now, this is the same, similar, word same. However, this time, we are dealing with multiple variables and constants within the parentheses and all being raised to the power. Okay, so we're now doing the power of a product. Okay, so we have 9xy all raised to the second power. That's an example. Okay, same thing as we did before, we're going to expand it. So this gives us 9xy times 9xy. And if you can see, it's now 9 to the second, x to the second, and now it's y to the second. Okay? The second example is 2, and it should be 2 to the power of 3. I know it says on your note catcher, it looks like a 3 next to it. It's to the power of 3. All of this is being raised to the power of 2. Same thing here, I'm going to expand it. So 2x to the third times itself. So now we can see I really have 2 to the second and x to the sixth. So for your rule, or power of a product is if you have some number or variable A and another base B all raised to the power of M, that now becomes A to the power of M, B to the power of M. So that is the rule for the power of a product. Now we're going to go into the triad. Okay, so triad number A is x squared times y to the power of 6. So the biggest thing with the power of product property rule is that you need to make sure you distribute that power. Because, like we did with our examples here, we just didn't do y squared. We brought it to everything in the parentheses. You gotta make sure everything stays equal. So in this case, it becomes x the second times 6, because we're really multiplying x squared 6 times, which gives us x to the 12th. And a little bit what we talked about in another lesson, if it's a variable by itself, it's really y to the first, because anything to the first power is itself. So y to the first times a power of 6 gives me y to the 6th. That is my answer. All right. Moving on to B, we have 4mn all raised again to the power of 3. Again, each base in this parentheses is being multiplied by a power of 3. So again, 4 being multiplied 3 times, so that's why it's the power of 3. M is also to the power of 3, and N is to the power of 3. All right, moving on to example C. We have negative 2g to the power of 4. Same thing, I'm containing my parentheses, or my negative within the parentheses. So it's negative 2 to the power of 4 and g to the power of 4. And if we were asked to evaluate it, negative 2 to the power of 4 is going to give us a positive 16, okay, which is on g to the 4th. If I didn't have a parentheses contained, this would be a negative 16. which is 9m to the power of 3 times n, and it's all being raised to the power of 4. So now I have 9 to the power of 4. M power of 3 is getting multiplied 4 times, so it really now becomes m to the 12th. And then n to the first power becomes n to the 4th power. With e, okay, we now have something being multiplied in the front of the parentheses. Okay, so we have 5 times 5x squared to the power of 4. The power of 4 only is represented with everything in the parentheses. So within it, I have 5 to the 4th, and then x to the 8th, because again, my rule is being distributed and I'm still multiplying my powers. So now I have 5 to the 4th, x to the 8th, bring down because I'm still multiplying by 5. So now 5 is being multiplied a total of 5 times, and I have x to the 8th. Okay, we can keep it in exponential form right now because we are not simplifying it or evaluating it all the way just yet. And then F is similar to question E. We have 3D to the power of 5, all power of 3 times D, same thing. I'm going to distribute my powers to each variable inside the parentheses. So I have 3 to the 3rd, d to the 5th power is being multiplied 3 times, so d is really being multiplied by a total of 15. Then I have another d being multiplied, so my final answer is 3 to the power of d, and then d to the power of 16. Okay, hopefully this lesson helped and you'll be able to complete the exercise. As always, email me or connect with me on my Zoom during my office hours for any questions.